Good evening, everybody. This is Big Easy bringing you live commentary of round 3 of season 6 Group 3 Century League Championship. Should be quite crazy liveries there. So we've literally joined in as cars and drivers are going through their warm-up periods and pre-qualifying. Quite a busy lobby tonight, I'm glad to say. 13 cars in here at the moment. Room for a couple more. So, looking at the championship table in the previous two rounds, both races were taken by Wendy Goo. So, we can see if Wendy Goo's marks tonight. The Nürburgring Grand Prix circuit is quite a challenging track in itself. Slopy corners, medium speed, high speed. Downhill approach into some corners. Particular ones to note are turn one. There could be mayhem there from the start. Very, very tight. We also have a very never-ending hairpin at turn eight, which is also a dangerous road. That would be a challenge. Turn 14. Tricky for the brakes being an uphill approach. And obviously opportunities to set up and overtake them in turn one. Just admiring some of the liveries with a little hook. Quite a busy car there. Racer in the Red Bull livery again. Bella once again likes to wear the checkered flag. Gold livery celebration of his Group 2 championship in 2022. Possibly one to watch. That's so it is. Fastest lap round 2. Another driver to watch. Pleasure craft showing a bit of chrome and bling. Gravel. people across Gran Turismo 7 and GT Sport are very familiar with Dragon Trail and Chicane of Death. I think the chicane at the top of that hill at the Nürburgring is a bit of a beast, to be fair. It's an exceptionally tight turn one. Just needs a bit of intellectual thinking on approach. My time race, and all three compounds of tyre need to be used, soft, medium and hard. In a night time race, do we need to think about track temperatures and how each tyre is going to perform, and would that dictate the length of the stint? Or are the length of the stint going to be determined by fuel? Will people try to fuel save? Many options, many choices. Sounded a V8 in that Mustang is just pure porn. So 15 cars in the lobby now. Looks like it's going to be a nice full grid. It is a shame with Gran Turismo 7 that we're limited to 16 cars in a lobby. Set of course obviously trounces that. It's up to 30 cars in a single race. That's an end to warm up. Now we get down to business, we're qualifying. Grid position is obviously critical with the nature of turn one. You want to be as far up this grid as possible to avoid dramas and troubles down at turn one. Straight out onto the track, shipping over. over each other a little bit. They'll be wanting to space themselves out during this warm-up lap, this out lap, ready for a flying lap. Everyone bar one car out on the track at the moment. Sherlock's leading them out on the flying lap. Like so it is. Fastest lap race two. Looking for a nice high grid position. Qualifying in Group 3, you want to pick up if you can a little bit of slip, but you've got the problem of dirty air with these Group 3 cars. So, yeah, you want a bit of slip on the straights, but in the turns you want to be a little bit off. So it is. 157.5. Jack, so it is. Time 1:54.3. That's certainly laying down the marker. Going out wide towards the end of the road. exact how it is. You're pretty determined to be having that pole position. You don't want no messing about in turn one by the looks of things. Lap four here again, such a penalty. Really trying to go with that. So he's going to run on fumes, looking for every single tent. It's going to be between these two guys, Jack Sowers and Randy Goo. Clean rubber, no fuel. Randy Goo, come to the chicane. Setting himself up for flying up. He's looking for 10 tents. He's up on his personal best. just under a tenth up on his personal best. We're about halfway through the lap here. It won't be happening on this lap. Going in for a second fastest lap. He's closed the gap to pole by just 2.5 tenths. Still looking for 5 tenths. It's going to make for an interesting race between these two guys, Jack Soldiers and Manny Goode. Quite a gap then to third, fourth, fifth, quite tight. Sixth, seventh, eighth. It's very, very, very tight, very congested. Lots to be had here on the last one lap. So it is, looks like he's just stretching his legs out here again, running extremely low on fuel, reasonably clean tyres. This could be a very, very quick time indeed. To Jack, so it is. It looks like the pole's firmly in his grasp. Wendy Goode's going to take up P2, Pleasurecraft P3. King Racer still running at the moment. A Vinny, I think A Vinny's new to the group, new to the championship. Well, a decent selection of cars in tonight's race. Porsche, a couple of Beetles. There's taking on the dreaded Merc. A couple of Mustangs, a couple of GTOs. GTO in Group 4 seems to be the meta car. It's looking pretty strong in Group 3 as well, to be fair. The BMW is an M3 and a Z4. Three Porsches. Here we go, start your engines, as the man once said. Turn one. Everyone seems to have made it through. Wobbly wobbly sloppy boys. That's so it is, it's made clean breakaway. Capitalizing on his speed. Seems to have happened to Indigo. Got them to fourth place. Interesting to have a look on the lead there. Let's look at Indigo for the moment. The Norton and Strath going on there. Indigo winning on the air tires. Days on hard tires. Momentarily swapping places. We've been in just a hole when he's got the inside line. Good driving by these three guys. Sheer look up the inside, complete the overtake. Now with the pressure from behind. Oh, and that's a spin. Look a look at it. Well, we're still pretty spaced out up front. Jack is still holding the lead, but Marky B is applying pressure. Well, clean around the inside. Think about a car on the inside. Take this back all the way up. Coming towards the end of the second lap, and Jack, so it is really just carrying on with the form that he's shown in qualifying. He's now got himself approaching a 5.5 second gap at the front. Marky P is doing extremely well, so hang on now, hang on. Plugging away, he's got a very healthy lead over third place Bella. Bella has come through the field, though, to come up into dirt, so he will have dealt with traffic. So it's doing quite well to have the gap that he's currently trying to conquer. So these hard tyres just don't seem to be working for Wendigo at all. Got back down to fifth place now, 11.5 seconds behind the leader. He is on soft tyres, so it will be a waiting game. This is the battle here. 4th, 5th and 6th seems to be where the action is on track at the moment. So we'll stick with these three guys and see how things develop. Are we by Vinny going to have a go here? Yeah, he's standing back. Good exit over that chicane. He's now favourite on the inside for a launch down the back straight. And it looks like he's going to complete that move. So good move there by Vinny. Good exit out of the chicane. Set up the inside line in the last corner. But quite the crash is coming back at him now on the inside of turn one. Backed out of it. I think he's just struggling to have enough room to get down there. So good defence there from Aiken. The pleasure craft himself now seems to be coming under pressure from Yugolo Hulk. And Yugolo Hulk has made this new down inside. Bit of a mismatch. How long is Wendigo going to hold on to these hard tyres? Is he fuel saving? Well, he has used a little bit less fuel. He's got eyes on making it 3 wins in a row in this championship. How far is he going to let that gap go? 19.5 seconds off the lead. will save it to you when you have a hard drive. How you manage things. Firewood man up against King Racer. Firewood man's just set his back to slack of the race. Got his car well rotated in turn one there, and it's put him right onto the back bumper of King Racer to be capitalised. Nice turret line. Porsche just seems to have that with a bit more balance about it. Seb's get through the bends a little bit more efficiency. While the Merc seems to be able to draw it back in the power areas. Well, we do have a few cars, a handful of cars that are running on hard tyres at the moment, so I was sort of expecting them to come in a bit further. At the top of the hill for the approaching to the chicane, give him the power. Held his nerve into the chicane and he's now pulling away. So again, it's another interesting battle of Porsche versus Mercedes. So in this section of the lap, the previous battle we've seen the Porsche able to pull away in the twisty turns and the Merc struggling to get rotation through the corners. And it looks like the same thing again. The Porsche has just got more ability and more finesse in the corners, whereas the Merc is a bit of a beast. Shows its power once it's able to open itself up. Look, he's extended that 4/10 lead now to almost 8/10. Again, clearly the Porsche has just got that nimbleness through the bends. side to get the power down a little bit quicker than the mirror. Jack's RTs just seems to have disappeared into the disappeared over the horizon. Running soft tyres. Couple of laps of fuel left in there. Quite comfortable out in front. Tyres are well worn now, but he's in a comfortable position. He'll sit in these tyres until he needs to put fuel in the car. Marky B doing extremely well in the Mustang. Quite a beast of a car to get through these twisty sections. Very menacing. Every opportunity for the Multi21 and Multi21 logos to pop out. Only in the Beetle. Doing very well. Only in on the medium tyres. He'll be in at the end of this lap, and there he is into the pits. Wendy goes into the pits to get rid of the hard tyres. Will we see him making moves now? As he left the two laps. Jack, so it is. We'll definitely have a pit stop over him at this stage. Despite this potential dramas at turn one, it's an extreme thing right into this pit. Little bit of argy-bargy in the opening acts, but everybody's sitting set down, got a little bit of space. It's a very clean, intelligent drive. Marky will be pitting. Glimpse of a spin there through the back window of Jack's car. Didn't quite catch who it was, but I made a good save of it. Marky B has stayed out of the window. No, he's in the pits. I do not know what I'm talking about. very, very close. Marky B on the pit exit. Looked like Yucca Hulk coming down. He was busy having a look at Bella for a challenge in turn one. But everybody's made it through. Seems to have lost quite a lot of time. Yes, stopping this for an extended period, completely filling his fuel tank. I think he's going to stay at one of those mediums now until he needs fuel again. So, sacrifice early on for a gain towards the end of the race. That's about it. That's how it is. Same strategy, mediums, full tank of fuel, and he's got a nice comfortable station. Oh look, running on the hards. Just then, it appeared like he'd been cleaning up his tyre, so I think he's been off a little bit. Fortunately, he was in a very, very strong position. Tyres sure looks on the hard tyres. The fuel loads are pretty similar. The Merc's a little bit more powerful on the straight, and the Porsche demonstrated a number of times in this race already. It's quite a number of the things. Let's see how this looks. Exit off here. Got the slipstream. Probably we'll see him moving to turn one, I think. And he's got that job done. Textbook move from when we go there, progressing up to fourth place. Distance, I'm just keeping an eye on Bella and Sherlock. And I'm convinced the battle will commence. Yes, the Merc is making moves. Right. Almost a switcheroo there. Thank you. Make some ground up here and set himself up and move down the home straight. The tight little section after turn one, if he just didn't make the move here, I don't think he'd make it. Craft decides to join this battle. Early defending, turns it into an attack on Sheerlock. Sheerlock's trying to hang on to it around the outside, got the inside for the next corner. Pleasurecraft with a very opportunistic move, almost made it a double overtake. Now he's going to set about closing down the lead in third place. Great progress in second place. He's opened up a 4 second gap over Bella. But Jack, so it is, is managing to hold that gap steady at 28 and 29 seconds. It'll be interesting to see if Wendy Goo can make any progress over the next 5-6 laps. Pleasurecraft has not given up on this battle at all. Good at it is what I mean. Defending on the inside line again. Pleasurecraft takes it wide. He's looking for the up and under. Almost alongside.
on that side.
Bella left himself a little bit much to do there to hold him inside of the right head to that corner and let that cruise straight in there. Finish the stint before we will have some I fully expect him to pull away now. Vinny, we haven't seen Vinny for a while. With a low hook. Pretty steady. Very, very spread out at the moment. So, this little crew here, trio of cars, so we've got most of the action that's happening at the moment. So, keep an eye from the back end of this blown-themed Porsche. Ella's not giving up on that position, he's hanging onto the back of the pleasure craft. And he'll be quite frustrated with how he lost that position. Halfway point of the race. Gap services is still holding that gap quite steady, although he has extended by a second. He's almost out of 30 seconds. And he goes second place, medium tyres. Jack's got a little bit more fuel in his car. This is short shifted. Short shift there. So he's using the gap just to short shift about 75% through his gearbox, saving the fuel consumption. The majority of it occurs in the last 25% of the rev bands. So just a little tiny bit of short shifting will actually save quite a bit of fuel. In a race where you need to refuel a couple of times, obviously the less amount of time you're sitting there having fuel go in, further down the road you'll be. Good pace, good strategy. At this stage, pretty much looking favoured to cruise. So, final podium position seems to be where the battle will be. They have spread out a little bit. We do have two medium shot cars, third and fourth, the hard tire car fifth. Next pit stop, they'll be swapping tires and that might give us some action later on in the race. Back on to he missed what happened. He's definitely been off the track somewhere. He was definitely cleaning his tyres up. He dropped from 4th down to ultimately 10th. But he's putting pressure in the 9th place now. Trying to make progress up in this course, but Porsche pitted later than the stone. The pressure tires, as we know, it's mingled in the corners. The stone, muscle car, tires are more worn. Michael B will have to work very hard to make progress on the racer. So we'll leave that one and we'll get back to Bella and company. That battle for a home podium place. Sheer luck appears to have had a problem somewhere because he's dropped back behind you in the Yugolau hook. So we've missed out with a piece of action. But like the lottery, innit? But we are in it, so we can win it. Than he wanted, really. Probably would have wanted to come through that curve and have made his move then inside into the chicane. So, yeah. Could ever have too good an exit, he'd have one there. So, same again here, good exit. Oh, the BMW has hit the barrier. That's job done. Unfortunate. Slow in down for about half a lap. Let's see what his steering's looking like. Oh, yeah. Needs a bit of four-wheel tracking, I'm afraid. So, yeah, so all his damage repaired himself, he's back to normal now. Good pressure applied though by Judicial, created that error, but I was fully expecting the beeper to make the overtake down the home straight at the tournament, so no odds really. Let's see if we can find another lead battle in this spread out field. This looks like wow. King Racer. Wibbly wobbly. Second and a half between the two. Let's have a look further in. Lily's gone through. Firewood man, is he just coming out of pits? Four cars closing up here, Wibbly Wobbly, Firewood man's pulled over. Firewood man got a problem. He seemed to be going rather slow earlier on. He seemed to pick him up now. He's not carrying any damage. He's got nice clean cards. I would call them nice, but they are clean. Maybe he's struggling on the yards with them being cold and he's just decided to get out of the way. Well, there's another example. He's spun off, back end's gone, them tyres are just not having it at all. He's now got real rear damage. He's going to slide, he's sliding a long way down. Very unfortunate. But Mercs, they're like the Titanic, they don't bloody well want the turn. So sheer luck, again, he's falling down the field a long way. I'm not sure if he's been back in the pits again. This looks like he's topped up the fuel. Tyres only look a couple of laps old. He's making some good progress on the back of Judicial here. Whoa! Judicial's absolutely slammed the door shut. You ain't having it. Sheer luck, do we have another go here, or will he be patient and wait for the home straight? He's been patient. Picked up that it. Oh, too much curve. 1 second to car. Lost a bit of time there. Good exit here. Onto the power early. Can he close the gap? No. Closing it now, but it still is going to be a second away. Somebody exiting the pit to complicate matters a little bit. And there's a yellow flag, so who's had enough? Can't see anything obvious on the monitors. Maybe the flagman just wants to exercise his own manager. So sheer luck is applying pressure here now to Judicial. He's had a go already, had the door firmly slammed. What's going to happen here? Door slammed again, parked it on the apex. Oh, yeah, bit pushy pushy. Not so sure. One for the stewards maybe. Judicial's hanging on to it, he's got the sheer luck's got the inside line. Leave that overtake. So he had to get his elbows out, I suppose. He's had the door slammed shut twice. He's in the faster car, so he's had to deal with the hard work. Good hard fair racing, I think.
Where can we find another one?
Was it used to come out of the pits? Yes, it was. He's topped up the view. He's got some nasty clean hard tyres. We've seen what they did to firewood in the Merc. How's the Hulk going to manage them? And can Shea look closing them? Onto the hard tyres. That'll be nine laps on those slippy sloppies. Well, Sherlock is really close to gap up now on Yugalook. Hulk is on hard tyres. You know, most of the guys we've seen on hard tyres have been struggling. We've seen Wendigo struggle at the start of the race with the hard tyres on, and he made progress and got himself back up to P2, albeit there's still a substantial gap up there. Sheer Luck has pretty much destroyed the two cars that were ahead of him on hard tyres, so he's making progress through the field. Well, out on the hard tyres in the Merc, so can we fare any better in these hard tyres? Let's see how it gets on. Looking at the monitors again, feeling it well spread out. There's cars on every sector of that. No real battles that I can see going on. So we keep an eye on Ballas here and see how he's got on with these hard tyres. Everyone else we've looked at is good. Softs. Yeah, was it really a battle? The move's done. Pleasurecraft is pulling away from Marky. He's put into fourth place. 5.5 seconds down on Vinny. Vinny's running on very worn out tyres. On the dregs of his fuel, so he'll be coming into the pit. So Pleasurecraft will be inheriting P3. So, Wendigo. So, P2, 1:04 down on P1. P1 will have to come into the pits shortly. But I can't see much changing between these two guys. Just hope nothing unfortunate happens to Jack in the closing stages of the race, but it looks like he's cruising to victory. He did dominate qualifying, he has dominated the race from the start, so fair play. Oh, where can you find the fan? What's going on? I can see the two cars very close to each other, but I can't pick them up. So, behind Mark Williams, the last car. straight out. Clean soft tyres. Actually reasonably clean mediums. So, and Darwin unlap himself. Interesting choice of pair, the Subaru VRZ. Beautiful car to run in the night races. It's a lovely dragon flying out its side pumps, particularly on deacceleration. One of my favourites in Group 3. Ray is struggling there, he just copped that, too much of that curve in the second part of the chicane. Oh, this wins for some. Yeah, what we've got here, 14, that's a lap situation. Firewood man, he really, really struggled on in them hard tyres in that car. Still looks like he's still struggling, to be fair. And the race leader comes through. Tires, the car in front. Can both make a mockery of all the drivers struggling with hard tires this evening and overtake the car in front on soft tires. Six laps left to go, Jack, so it is, 58 and a half seconds out in front, well in control of this race. He also holds fastest lap. I can't see anything changing there. It would be a travesty if he loses that P1 at this stage. Wendigo struggled at the beginning of the race. Purely strategy choices, kicked off on the hard tyres from P2, got swallowed up in turn one and found himself down in 6th, 7th place. Finishing the race on soft tyres, he's up into P2, under no threat. But it was just interesting to see the P1 and P2 go at it at the start of the race on soft tyres. Wendigo has won the first two races of this, first two rounds of this championship, and Jack So It Is, I think, joined in later on, and he's certainly making his intentions clear. Pleasure Craft has been pretty consistent throughout this race and is in a comfortable P3 at this point. Bella, the Merc, extremely good performance considering, you know, using the Merc for different cars for different drivers. So sheer luck, medium tyres, relatively water, just over quarter wall. Bella hard tyres, maybe an 8 wall, 10 fuel, 7 fuel and sheer luck. So we may have a battle develop here towards the latter stages, so we'll keep an eye on the monitors on that one. Nothing going on with King Ransom, pretty sterile. Hey Vinny. It's a respectable P7. I think Hey Vinny's just joined in the championship as well, finding his feet. So, pretty solid performance. Finishing strongly on soft tyres. Hello Hulk. Pretty fast guy in the Group 4s. Pretty much middle of the road in the Group 3. Interesting choice, winning the M3. I think we'll focus on this closing stages. We'll focus on P4 and P5. I said earlier on, P5 is on the medium tyres. They are a little bit more worn than Bella's car in front on the hard tyres. They're carrying a similar amount of fuel. This stage, the only place where we can really see a battle developing is going to be the race starts pretty much settled down. Quite neutral. Seems to be looking like they're going to stay put unless anybody makes any dreadful mistakes, which of course can happen. We're looking at a 50 minute race here, so around about 40-45 minutes concentration tends to start to suffer. So we may see another mistake. Look, he's looking for the lines, he's looking for the apexes, but the medium tyres just don't want to fight anymore. She's getting too tense. And like I said, Bella is on the hard tyres. Sherlock is struggling, Bella's going to be struggling. Yeah, and again, for all its woes in the twists and turns, once that mare gets onto a straight piece of track, it's going. In GT Sports, they had this Lewis Hamilton challenge, and I'll never understand how that bloke was able to get that bloody Mercedes through the corners the way he did. I tried my damnedest, but I never beat his times. I picked up a few goals, but never managed to beat his times. Then again, he is a second-time world champion. So again, in the twists and turns, the Porsche is closing up on the Merc. And once we get through these couple of corners, expect the Merc to pull away again for a little bit. So, pretty sterile, but looking at the monitors, I still can't see any battles on. Oh, and there's a mistake from Bella. sheer luck, straight in there. He's not going to give that one up. Half a chance he's grabbing it. So sheer luck up to P4. Fortunate error there from Bella. He's been driving really consistently throughout this race. But like we've seen before, the Mercedes on hard tyres, it ain't gonna play ball. His good mate Firewood will be lamenting to him post race, swapping notes on the woes of Mercs and hard tyres. Back up from 1910. Judicious. Soft tyres, well worn. Wibbly wobbly. Hard tyres, relatively clean. This will be interesting. The bad cousins. The wee Porsche. The bad lads. So judicious, really closing up now. Looks like Judicial had the move done, but he's going to have another go. He's having another go here. Round the inside, taking loads of that curve, hooking up the apex, pushing it out. Oh, and he's made that place. So, valiantly baffled by Wibbly Wobbly. He did come back of him on the initial overtake down the inside of turn one. Fought back bravely, took Judicial by surprise to find himself still alongside. Didn't waste the second opportunity he was presented with. And again, it just shows the woes of hard tyres on this track, because Judicial's on very, very worn soft tyres, and managed, look how worn those tyres are. He's managed to pull right away from the relatively clean, hard tyre shop course, which we've seen all through the race. He's quite windy in the corners. Good battle. So, what the monitor shows. Two battles on. Two cars got to be back now because I'm not catching them up and I go forward through the field. Well, now the Firewood man has managed to wear the surface off his hard tyres, he's actually getting a bit of a tune out of his car. Was that the kiss of death? I shall leave him alone for the rest of the race. Oh my days. He'll be a hit man after me. So, Jack has crossed the line, P1. Then you go P2. Pleasurecraft P3. Those positions have been pretty sterile for this latter half of the race. Fantastic drive from Jack, so it is. Absolutely dominated this round. And you go. You certainly had to go up the throne down. So come back next week and try again. you all for a cracking race. Plenty of battles all through the field. Standard of driving was exceptionally good today. There was some hard battles. I dare say there'll be a few Stewart inquiries. But in the main, good, honest, hard battling. Credit everybody involved. Well done, Multi21, and I'll see you all again soon. Ta-da!